Hello everyone, I, Ms. Bhavna Danesh Munod, welcome you all in Agricultural Development Trust, Shardabai Pawar, Mahila Arts, Commerce and Science College, Shardanagar, Baramati. Good day, dear students. Let us start with our first chapter in Organization, Commerce and Management of 11th Standard Children, that is Introduction of Commerce and Business. So in this chapter, we'll study about what is commerce, what is business, what is employment, what is profession. Commerce relates to production of goods and services, and business relates to distribution of goods and services. So we'll study in this chapter that is related to commerce and business. Now, children, all human beings have different types of needs. All will have, individual will have their needs, their satisfaction level will be different. So they keep themselves busy and they do some activity throughout their life. So all activities can be classified as economic and non-economic activity, children. See, if you can see in the diagram, economic activity as well as non-economic activity, that is human activities, it is divided into two types, non-economic and economic. Now, non-economic activity means what, children? When you work but you get nothing in return. When you work for something, you get nothing in return, that is called as non-economic activity. And when you work and you get money in return, you get paid for that job, that is called as economic activity. And under economic activity, then children, business will come, profession will come, and employment will come. So we have to study in this chapter related to profession, business, and employment. So human activities divided into two types, economic and non-economic activities. Non-economic activities are those human activities, children, which are performed to satisfy personal, say our personal things, social, religious, cultural and sentimental requirements without any monetary expectations. For example, reading books, say, or serving people or cooking food by mother. That is what non-economic activity. We are expecting nothing in return. Doing work but expectations are nothing from other person. That is called as non-economic activity, children. Then what is economic activity? So activities that involve production, distribution, consumption of goods and services for money or money's worth at all levels within a society is called as economic activity. So example, say worker working in a factory. So thus economic activities facilitates earning livelihood. So economic activities will involve what? Production, distribution, consumption of goods and services for money or money's worth at all levels within a society. So it will be example worker working in a factory, as well as the people who are working for their livelihood, they will come under economic activity. Now we'll see what is business, the first part of non-economic activity, children. So there are two definitions of business. The first one is according to Professor Haney. So according to Professor Haney, business has been defined as: business activities are all those human activities which are directed towards the production and processing of wealth. And Professor Pride, Hughes and Kapoor has defined business as, children, the organized efforts of individuals to produce and sell for profit the goods and services that satisfies society's needs. These are coming under business. So business means what, children? The activities, all those human activities which are directed towards the production process and wealth processing, that is called as business by Professor Haney. And Professor Pride, Hughes and Kapoor has told about business that the organized efforts of individual to produce and to sell for profit the goods and services that satisfies society needs, that is called as business. Then we are going to see one by one the characteristics of business, children. That is, business is an economic activity. Business will involve two parties. business is profit motive, production of goods and services are there, exchange of goods and services are there in business, business deals in goods and services, there is always continuity in dealings. Uncertain returns are there, element of risk is more in business, and the 10th characteristics of business is customer satisfaction. So, definition of business we have saw, now we'll see one by one the characteristics of business. The characteristics are also even called as features of business, children. Now, the first characteristics of business is that business is an economic activity. Economic activity, already we have seen. What is economic activity? When we work or when we do job. Why people do job? To get salary, to get money back in return. So, when we work and we get money in return, that is called as economic activity. So, your business comes under economic activity, children. So, it is done for money, for livelihood. It is not because of love, affection, feelings and sentiment. So, here in business, we will not have emotional. We will not have feelings. Like for example, our mummy cooks special food for us on a birthday. That is her emotion, her love, her affection. But that doesn't come in business. It will come under non-economic activity, children. Then business always involve two parties are there. Always. Business will not be with one person. For business, maximum there should be two persons, children. So, minimum two parties are involved in business. That is buyer and seller. See, whenever a seller will be there, buyer will be there. Only seller will not be possible to have in business. Only buyer will not be there in the market if a seller or customer is not there. So, two parties, that is buyer and seller, both will be required for business. So, business transaction is a result of an agreement between the buyer and the seller, which may be oral or written. Then, the third one is profit motive. Now, see children, the third characteristics of business is what? Profit motive. So, the basic purpose of business is what? To earn profit from its activities. So, businessmen always tries to maximize their profits either by increasing the volume of sales or reducing its cost. So, it is the spine of business which keeps the business going on the long term. So, the amount of profit may differ from business to business. What is the basic purpose of business? What? It is the profit from its activities. Businessmen try to maximize profits either by increasing the volume of sales or reducing its cost. It is the spine of business which keeps the business going on in the long term, as well as the amount of profit may be different from business to business. So, business is an economic activity. Business always involves two parties, children. And whatever we do in business, that is regarding profit motive. Whoever will work in business, that is for profit motive. Then the fourth characteristic in business, that is production of goods and services. Now children, before exchanging this goods and services, they should be produced by business enterprises. So goods are either manufactured or procured from the supply with the aim of selling it further to the consumer for profit. So, production of goods and services means what? Before exchanging goods and services, the goods should be produced. So, who is producing this? By the business enterprises. So, either the goods are manufactured or they are brought from somewhere. Procured means brought from the supplier. So, with the aim why? They will be distributed to the consumers, to the sellers in the aim of having profit. So, production of goods and services is also one of the characteristics or features of business. Then exchange of goods and services. Now what is there in this exchange of goods and services? That business involves transfer of goods and services directly or indirectly with money or money's worth. Monetary exchange is the exchange with money. Monetary exchange means what? Whatever things are exchanging, we are exchanging money. For example, we are purchasing a notebook, we are giving money. Cash, example, buying notebook for cash. On the other hand, in case of barter exchange is what we have studied, children, this. Barter exchange means what? Exchange of goods with goods. Now you will know in this economics second chapter money, that first barter system was there in olden days, children. With goods, the goods were exchanged. Like suppose a wheat of jawar is there, so you will give that wheat of jawar and you will get one cup of milk. like that the goods by exchange with goods, that is called as barter system. And monetary system means what? Monetary exchange means what? You are selling something for money. You are buying notebook for cash, that is called as monetary exchange. So, here they have told regarding in case of barter exchange, goods and services are exchanged for some other products. Example, wheat is exchanged for rice. So, if goods are produced for own consumption, that is stitching a dress for daughter, it cannot be called as a business activity. But stitching of dress in tailoring shop and taking stitching charges for that is a business activity, children. See, when you are stitching, example, simple example they have given. Now, a mother is stitching a dress for her daughter. That is not called a business activity. But in that case, if a mother is working in a factory and she is stitching clothes over there in a factory, she is getting monthly salary, that is called as a business activity. So, if similarly goods are donated or given as a gift, then it cannot be considered as business activity. Now, the next characteristics of business is what? Dealings, children, in goods and services. Now, every type of business interaction is concerned with either goods or services. In the absence of goods and services, business cannot take place. So, these goods are consumer goods or capital goods. However, services created for business purpose are intangible, which are essential for doing the business. So, example, transportation, banking, insurance, etc. So, every type of business transaction, children, we do, there is dealing in that. Whatever services we do, goods or services, in the absence of these goods and services, business cannot take place. So, these goods are consumer goods or capital goods. And however, services created for business purpose are intangible, which are essential for doing the business. Example, transportation, banking, insurance, etc. Then, children, next point, in business, uncertain returns are there. Next feature. Now, in business, they are never predictable. The businesses are never predictable or guaranteed. Businessmen may earn profit or suffer a loss. So, business are not guaranteed. They are uncertain returns in business. They either may have profit or they may suffer a loss. So, dealings in goods and services with business is done. Uncertain returns are there. And the last feature of business is element of risk, children. Yes. You do a business, there are many risk factors in business. So, risk, say, it comes with business. It is the key element of every business, children, which is concerned with exposure to loss. So, it is due to some unfavorable or undesirable event. Every business will have some or the other risk. So, intensity of risk can be minimized but cannot be avoided. Certain factors are beyond the control of businessmen, like changes in consumer taste, likes, dislikes, fashion, changes in the methods of production, fire, theft, natural calamities, etc. So, no business is free from the above mentioned factors. So, element of risk is the last feature, say, or last characteristics of business, but it is there. Every business has a key element of risk. Risk factor is everywhere. This risk is, it can may have uncertain profit or it may be in loss. We can't predict that what will happen in future. So, the certain factors of businessmen, or say in business, it is not controlled. Businessman has to go through the phases, like there will be changes in fashion, there will be consumer taste change, likes, dislikes will be there of consumer, we cannot predict them. There will be fire, there will be natural calamities, etc. There are risk in business. So, these characteristics and features we have seen in business, children, that is, first, it is an economic activity. Business always involves two parties, that is, buyer and seller should be there. Business always aims at profit making. Production of goods and services will be there. Exchange of goods and services will be there. Dealings in goods and services will be there. Uncertain returns will be there. An element of risk will be there. So, goods. See, the consumer goods are tea, milk, pencil, etc. And capital goods in business are machinery, plant, furniture, etc. Children, keep in mind. Now, the next feature, that is the 9th and 10th one characteristics, are related to consumer capital goods. Means what? Consumer goods are tea, milk and pencil children. And capital goods are machinery, plant and furniture. Now in business, the 9th point, that is 9th feature, is continuity in dealings. So every business requires regularity in transaction. One single transaction does not constitute business. Example, if a person sells his own motor car and earns profit, it will not be considered as a business activity. But if he's a car dealer, he sells and purchases cars regularly, then it is considered as business activity. Yes, continuity in dealings. You do a business that will be in continuity process. Now see, some people, they want to sell a two-wheeler. They will put on Facebook, advertisement will be there, they will talk to their friend and they will sell their motorbike. But if they stop, only they have to sell one bike, it is not called as a business. But they have a shop, automobile shop, they are selling two-wheelers, then it is called as business. That is continuity in dealings. Then customer satisfaction is one more important characteristics of business. That is customer satisfaction, ultimate aim in economic activities. And business is not an exception to it. Modern business believes in satisfying the customers by providing quality products and services at a reasonable price. So the purpose of the business is to create and retain the customers. So customer satisfaction is also one more important point in business. So customer satisfaction is an ultimate aim in economic activities and business. There is no choice regarding that. Customer satisfaction, the main part of the business is to focus on customer, whether he is satisfied or whether he likes your product or not. That is more important part. So modern business believes in satisfying the customer by providing quality products and services at a reasonable price. So the purpose of the business is to create and retain the customers. So we saw all the 10 points regarding characteristics of features of business. Now we come to the next point of the chapter, children, that is profession. Now we all know professional persons are who? Doctors, lawyers, CAs, etc. So what is the meaning of profession actually in a non-economic activity? See, so profession is that part of economic activities, children, under which a person uses his educational knowledge and special skill to render services for earning, say, some income, that is doctor, liar, lawyer, chartered accountant, etc. Now what are the features of profession? We'll see one by one. Now features of profession, that is first one, aim. Now every profession, each one practices, children, to earn money, to have some money, and also to render services to their clients and solve their problems. So one feature of professional persons is aim. They work for money, they practice to earn money, they also render, give services to clients and solve their problems. So they render services to their clients and their problems. Then the second one is qualification. Now a profession can be practiced only after a prescribed qualification, after acquiring that particular qualification. So each profession has a certain set of body of knowledge, children. This knowledge has to be systematic. Only by and formal training will be given to them. One cannot practice profession unless the knowledge is acquired. So when you are having a professional degree, when you have been given trained, then only you can practice your profession. Now for example, children, doctors, to have a doctorate degree, you have to be first educated. That means you should be passed out in MBBS, Bachelor of Medical Science. When you have that degree in hand, when you have practice, then only a professional degree will be handed to you. That is a doctor's degree. So qualification is utmost important regarding profession. Then the third one is financial returns. The third point. Now what is there in financial returns? That professional get fees in exchange of their services. Income received by professional is not fixed. Professionals can employed in an organization or self-employed. A working chartered accountant gets salary, but those who practice privately, that is self-employed, gets fees. Now see, financial returns means every professional person will have different types of whatever earning of income will be there. CAs will have different money, doctors will have their professional fees different. engineers, architects, interior designers will have their different fees. So everyone practices according to their training, as well as fees will be charged differently from them. Financial returns. So professionals can be employed in any organization or self-employed, and a working chartered accountant, they have told, get salary. But some people who practice also privately, they will have self-employed, they will get fees differently. Then the fourth one is capital. Now profession can be practiced independently, or professionals accept a job in my organization. So independent practicing professional requires huge capital for setting his practice. It differs from profession to profession. Now capital C, children. See, every profession has different type of financial requirement. Now suppose I say a doctor, for example, I'm giving you a doctor. He has taken his degree, he has completed his training, now he is perfect, he is confident that he should have his own hospital. So when a doctor thinks of having his own hospital, more capital is required, more finance is required. So that will take more practice and more capital. From profession to profession will be different. CA will have his own office requirement. So they have told that huge capital for setting up their business or setting up their practice will be different for different professionals. Doctors will have different finance required. CAs, lawyers for their offices will have different requirements. So capital will be different according to the profession. Then the next point in this is registration and membership, which we are studying, children, that is professional characteristics and features. So what is there under this registration and membership? We will see in the next period, children. Till then, bye and thank you.